QPSK and DQPSK modulation and demodulation trainer. This is a set of two trainers, and order code for these trainers are 40620 and 40621. Both are included. QPSK stands for quadrature phase shifting method, and DQPSK stands for differential quadrature phase shifting method. This kit initiates user to various data conditioning and carrier modulation techniques. In the PSK or phase shifting, modulation for all digits data, that is 1 and 0, the modulated output switches between the in phase and out of phase components of modulating frequency. When phase is equal to 0, data is equal to 1. In this PSK method, when phase is equal to 180 degree, the data is equal to 0. The type is called binary PSK, which is binary phase shifting. But in quadrature PSK, which is QPSK, phase has 4 different values like 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degree. They are used in the carrier modulation of differentially coded D-bit pair. One of 4 carriers is transmitted at a time. Now we move on to the circuit description and kit description, followed by the experiments. So this is our trainer kit for QPSK, DQPSK modulation and demodulation trainer. Order code for these kits are 40620 and 40621. These both kits are included. This is the modulation section and this is the demodulation section. The power on off switch is given here. The user manual is also provided, patch codes in accessories, and this is the power connector to connect 620 kit to 621 kit. So the circuit description is as goes. These are the components which are used to form the different circuits available at this circuit section. So we start with the clock generator. This is the S clock generator, and this is the data generator, and these are the switches to simulate the data which we are going to modulate. Now this is the NRZ coder, non-return zero coder, and this is the D-bit conversion sector, and this is the differential encoder 1 and differential encoder 2. These are the carrier generators for different phase difference, which is 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degrees. These are the carrier modulators, in which first section is of carrier inputs and other is control inputs. Now these are the fault switch also provided for creating different type of faults during the operations. Now we move on to the next kit. Similarly, there are also components which are used to make the different circuits over there. This is the modulation input which we get from the modulation circuit. These are the square 1, square 2, which square the signal of modulation. Now which is the filter which is provided here. Now after that, this is the F by 4 generator and sampling clock generator with different sampling rates. Now in front of this, there is an adder which adds the signals and fed them to envelope detector for both signals. Here the signals are decoded from adding and division of RX clock recovery. After that, we will get the I bit and Q bit here as an output of demodulated. Here differential encoder also provide in this section,
which is differential decoder 1 and differential decoder 2. These are the phase sync and reset buttons. For any type of delay, if we find during the operation, we can press the reset switch. And this is the data decoder. After modulation and demodulation, the data will be decoded from this section and data output will be shown at the CRO. Now we move on to the practicals. For this, first we will do the practical on 40620K. So our first experiment is study of debit pair data coding technique of NRZ non return to 0 L data format. The block diagram and the connection diagram is shown at the manual here. We will do the connection as per the manual. For this, we will connect data in to data generator and connect S clock output to S clock in the debit conversion sector. Now connect NRZ L data to data in. So these are the connections. Now we power on the circuit. For getting the experiment, we will get the output waveform from different sections of different values. But first of all, make sure the all fault switches are on the on conditions and the switch 1 data simulated is at the same position which is described in the block diagram. These are the data simulation switches. Always verify these switches which are at the same positions or not. Now we will observe the waveform at different positions. For this, we connect CRO to ground and the positive lead. First we connect it to transmitter clock and we can observe the clock frequency at the CRO. Now we observe the output of data generator. The data generator output is also shown at the CRO. Now we move on to the NRZ data output. The NRZ data output also shown at the CRO. Now we will move on to the IBIT output. The IBIT output is shown at the CRO. Now we get the qubit output, which is also shown at the CRO. All waveforms are also given in the user manual. You can verify that you are getting the right waveform or not. The conclusion of this practical is the data are coded in D-bit, which generates a data signal I in phase consisting in voltage level corresponding to the value of first bit of the considered pair for a period of 2-bit intervals, and a data signal Q in quadrature consisting in voltage level corresponding to the value of the second bit of the pair for duration of 2-bit intervals. When you observe the waveform, you get the same conclusion. Now we move on to the next experiment, which is study of differential of debit pair data. For this, we make the connection as per the block diagram shown in the user manual. For this, we connect data input to data generator's output. We connect NRZ data to data in, connect S clock clock generator's output to clock in the debit conversion. Now connect I bit to the differential decoder encoder 1 and Q bit to the differential encoder 2. Now at the differential encoder we will observe the output waveforms with the help of a CRO. For this, connect ground terminal of CRO to ground and other terminal of 2 data out. So this is the I bit differential data waveform which is shown at the CRO. Now we will observe the Q bit data output waveform. The differential encoder gives a delay in between and makes them the differential output. So as we concluded from this experiment is when input data to differential encoder contains 1, the output of the differential encoder makes transition from its previous state, and when the input data contains continuous 1s, then output of the differential encoder toggles between 1 and 0. So this is the output and conclusion from this experiment. Now we move on to the experiment number 3, which is the observation of constellation diagram and to study the bandwidth efficiency of QPSK. For this, make the connection as per the block diagram given in the user manual. So we connect data in to data generator as clock generator's output to clock in, energy data output to data in. Now we observe the waveform over the constellation diagram. Now for the output of this practical, first connect CRO probes to the ground and I-bit. You will get the decoded output of I-bit. Now from the other channel, we will observe the output waveform of Q-bit. This is the decoded output. Here. Now we will observe the constellation diagram. For this, connect X channel of CRO to the I-bit and Y channel of CRO to the Q-bit. Now we will get the both waveform on the CRO. For constellation diagram, turn the CRO in XY mode. You will get this constellation diagram, or you will be able to find out the dot diagram of this also. You can also observe the constellation diagram given in the user manual, which is same as shown at the CRO. For calculation of bandwidth efficiency, you can go through the formula and theoretical description mentioned in the user manual. Now it is observed from the constellation diagram that the symbol generated due to I bit and Q bit have 4 possible values and lines in 4 quadrants. Also, the constellation diagram, we can see it. The distance between two symbols is same and can conclude that after each time, either BE or B0, that is I-bit or Q-bit, can change, but both cannot change at the same time. After each time of TB, the transmitted signal, if it changes phases by 90 degree rather than by 180 degree, as in BPSK. And bandwidth efficiency generally depends on the number of bits transmitted simultaneously. So this is the observation of this practical. Now we move on to the next practical. Now we move on to the next experiment, which is quadrature phase shift keying modulation techniques. For this, we required both the kit together and we performed the experiment on this both kit. For this, first we have to give the power to the 621 kit. For this, first power of the 620 trainer kit's power and connect this adjoining power connector to the other kit. Now we power on the circuit, we can see the power is on the both kit, the both kits are power on. Now we make the circuit diagram for this experiment as per the block diagram given in the user manual. For this, connect data in to data generator, NRZ to data in, S clock output to clock in, I bit to the control input C1 and Q bit to the control input C2. Now connect carrier generators signal signal 1 to input 1, signal 2 to input 2, signal 3 to input 3, and signal 4 to input number 4. Now connect the modulated output signal to the modulated input signal of 621 kit. Now connect I bit output to I bit in, Q bit output to Q bit in, and clock output to clock in. At data output, we will get the waveforms for the demodulated output. Now we observe the waveform at different sections of this panel. Now in quadrature, the D-bit phase shift, so in D-bit conversion sector, since we know I and Q can take either 0 or 1 value, maximum 4 possible symbol can be generated, which is 00, 01, 10 and 11. According to the symbol generated, one of the 4 sign carrier will be selected. The relation between symbol generated are given in this table, which is D-bit and phase shift table. Now we connect the CRO to observe the waveform at different points. For this, at the kit number 620, we will observe the waveform of input energy data.
Which is as shown in the CRO.
Now we will observe the carrier frequency SIN1 signal, which is a sine wave. You can see at the CRO, this is at the 0 degree. Now for 90 degree, similarly a sine wave is produced, but at the 90 degree phase shift. Now the other sine wave, this is 180 degree phase shift, and the other is 270 degree phase shift. Now observe the I bit output. And Q bit output from the D bit conversion. Now we move on to the 40621 kit. Now at the 40621 kit, we observe the waveform. First we observe the modulation output, which is given to the modulation input. You can see the waveform here. This is the modulation output, also shown in the user manual. You can verify it. Now the first square, then observe waveform of second square, now we observe the waveform of second square. The second square is very high frequency. There is a slightly a lower waveform. Now we observe the filter output. Now we move on to the sampling clock generator. These are the sampler 1, 2, 3 and 4, also shown at the manual. Now we move on to the DM1 output. Which is as shown in the manual. Now we observe the DMQ output. Which is same as DM1. But in a quadrature pulse. Now we observe the data output. Sorry, first we observe the I bit input, which is the decoded output from this gate. Now this is the Q bit output, which is also decoded from this circuit. Now we will get the data output at the data decoder. This is the same as the data input which we have given to the modulation section from the energy data decoder. So this is the QPSK demodulation circuit, which is going through the and start through the 40620 kit, and the modulation output will be occurred at the 40621 demodulation kit. Now we move on to the last experiment, which is differential quadrature phase shift keying modulation technique. For this we have to just modify some connection which we have done already. Just at the differential encoder 1, with the I bit and add the differential encoder 2 with the Q bit and give the output of differential encoder 1 to the control input C1 and output of differential encoder 2 to the control input C2. Similarly, at the demodulation gate, the I bit output from the QPSK modulator will be goes through the differential decoder 1 and the Q bit output will goes through the differential encoder decoder 2, and the both output of this I bit and Q bit will be give to the I bit and Q bit at the data decoder section. Now we observe the output waveform. The remaining waveform of the sections will be the same, just I and Q bit waveforms are different. And the modulated demodulated data output is as shown. This is the differentially encoded demodulation. Now from these practicals we will get the conclusion that the differential coding of I and Q bit data to be transmitted makes the bit pair to be transformed into phase variation of the carrier. This way the receiver recognizes the pair each time it detects a phase shift of the modulated carrier independently from its absolute phase. So that's the QPSK and DQPSK modulation and demodulation techniques from this kit. For any queries, please refer to the instruction manual and or you can contact to the Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.